The investigation continues into if a Providence police cruiser hit a moped Sunday afternoon, leaving a 24-year-old man in a coma. Police releasing two new videos today leading up to that crash. Commissioner of Public Safety Stephen Perry says the videos are helpful. However, neither show definitive evidence of if that cruiser hit the victim, Jamal Gonsalves. This comes after a rally for Gonsalves in Providence last night turned violent. Providence police say they arrested 21 people and an officer was injured. Gonsalves' family telling 12 News they do not condone any violence toward police. They also say Gonsalves took a turn for the worst last night, but doctors are currently monitoring his condition.
And the Target 12 investigators have been going through police and fire radio calls from that incident, piecing together the response to the chaotic Sunday afternoon scene and the moments leading up to that crash, as well as what happened after. Tim White joins us in studio now to break down what he's learned. And Tim, I know you've combed through hours of this audio, so can you explain for folks exactly what you were listening to?
Yeah, Kim, a lot of people have heard police and fire department scanner traffic, and some of those frequencies are recorded, so we can take a look back at some incidents, and we often do this to try and build a timeline of an incident. So, you know, when a call came in and how long it took for first responders to get there, etc. Now, remember, these are not 911 calls, but rather communication between dispatch and police and firefighters over their radios.
All right, so we know that the crash involving that moped, it happened just before 6 p.m.
Right.
As you've gone through these recordings, you're noticing it started much earlier.
Brian, the first call came in actually at 4:03 p.m. There was a large gathering of ATVs at India Point Park along with dirt bikes. And when police showed up, that group began to disperse and rode further into the city. And if I could, I want to play some audio to show you what police say they were seeing.
I'm following one of those scooters, not stopping. I'm going to break it off because he's going to hurt himself.
Some for this. Dirt bikes, ATVs, motorcycles, and they just keep coming. There's hundreds of them.
Well, they're heading towards downtown now, just running pedestrians off the sidewalk into the roadway.
There's got to be at least 300 or 400 of them occupying the entire lane. They're still coming.
Now, this went on for a while. Police continued to monitor and trail this group throughout the afternoon.
And Tim, obviously still a lot of questions remaining about the crash itself, whether that cruiser actually hit the moped. So what did the audio tell you, if anything, about that moment?
Well, police scanner traffic showed that police called for an ambulance at 5:50 p.m. Now, a fire engine company was there within 3 minutes, and firefighters knew right away that Jamal Gonsalves had sustained serious injuries. As they were waiting for the rescue to get there, firefighters reported that Gonsalves had sustained a head injury. He was unconscious and was having trouble breathing. At one point, you could hear an officer ask the dispatcher to have the rescue step it up. Now, the rescue arrived 6 minutes after the initial call, but clearly for the people on the scene, it must have felt like an eternity.
So many pieces to this story.
Yes.
Talk about that.
And all of the police department, as you heard from Commissioner Perry, they're trying to put those pieces together to determine if the cruiser actually made contact with the bike.
And still looking for more video if it's out there, of course.
That's right.
All right. Target 12 investigator Tim White, our thanks to you as always. If you would like to hear the radio traffic from that incident, Tim's report is online right now. You can listen to it at WPRI.com.